saw. And about the transitory nature of human affairs. And about halfway through writing this song, I realized this would be a really good song for George Jones. And a couple of years after I wrote the song, George Jones was actually going to record it. This is a 100% true story that explains why all songwriters are kind of insane. Because that's a huge honor. I was thrilled. I was ready to hang it up. I go out, if I get George Jones and sing myself, I'm done, you know. And so I was going to fly out to Nashville for the recording session. I had a little suitcase packed, I had a ticket in my hand, and one of those cliche moments from a bad movie, I'm literally walking out the front door, and my phone rang. I'm like these kids today, they have their phones everywhere, and they're horrible fax machines. And I had to decide, how am I going to answer them? Went in and answered the phone, and it was a guy from Nashville. I said, oh, no, maybe you come out. But why? Goes, well, it. And I never quite figured out who it was. Could have been the record company, could have been his manager, could have been his producer, could have been his dog, I'm not sure. But it was decided that the song was, and this is in quotations, too country. So, I said, I didn't know that all songwriters were a little insane.
Say a word.
would you leave? There's no need for a long goodbye. You're not the one she's missing. Every night about the news time. And every night about this time. Every night.